What's up, girls? It's Blaze, and welcome back to my channel. Hopefully you can tell the quality is even better this time as I've got my new ring light. I've just set it up. It came yesterday. Hooray! Oh my god, I'm so excited. My videos actually look decent. So exciting. So today, as you can tell by the title, I've got a Spooky Books Club unboxing to do for you guys, and this one is Memento Mori, which I'm so excited about. Freaking anything to do with like Victorian era, death, Spooky Books Club, I'm in love with. So that's what we've got today. I will show you the sticker. So as always, I've done my makeup inspired by Spooky Books Club, which I'll insert a closer up clip here. It's basically just like a cut crease with like grey and black in the crease, and then this like chandelier detailing along the edges, which I followed from one of Toxic Tears videos, which I'll link below if you haven't seen it, because it's a really good tutorial. And then I'm wearing grey lipstick from Primark. My top thingy is a dress from Primark again, and my headpiece was from Asda at Halloween a couple of years ago, so it's just like a headband with a veil attached. And a fun fact, I used to wear this to college every day with the veil on, so I didn't have to speak to people. Also, before I get into the unboxing, I just wanted to mention, if you're super interested in Memento Mori like I am, and the dead, especially the Victorian era, there's a really cool book that you could check out, Beyond the Dark Veil, Postmortem and Mourning Photography. It's really cool, so I'll just show you like a snippet from the book. I got this for Christmas from my boyfriend's mum, and it's just so cool. There's loads of chapters with loads of cool imagery in and information. So yeah, there's all kinds of chapters in there. Remembering death, memory keepers, the soul and its substitutes, death in the 19th century, stuff like that. So I'll link where you can find this below if you're interested in that. I thought this would be a good time to mention this book. Also, one more little side note, please excuse my nails, they are awful. I've just removed the acrylics I had on for like well over a month, and it was not good. I'm not getting acrylics ever again after the destruction that it has caused. Awful. So, anyway, let's get right into it. Okay, so here we go. This box smells so good. It smells like rosemary. I'm not sure, it definitely smells herby. I can definitely smell rosemary. There's the card that I'm not going to read yet. Oh, I really hope it's like incense or herbs for magic or something. Oh god, I'm excited. I can barely talk when I'm doing these videos because I just get too excited. So here are our doodad things. Oh my god, cute things. Okay, right, let's just pull things out. Right, so the first thing I'm drawn to is a candle. Oh, I got the scent completely wrong. It is a lavender candle. You can see there, the card's got like a little skull and stuff on it, cute little pattern. Lavender natural soy wax candle. I can't believe I thought that was rosemary. Oh, it smells so good. This would be so good to keep by your bed if you're having trouble sleeping, and then just light it at night and just smell the lavender and fall asleep. That is so cute. I love that. Right, the next thing, oh, I think that was supposed to go in the top. Yeah, there was like a little cork that was loose in there, so I believe that is popped in the top, so that's probably why my box smelled so good, because the little cork came out. So everything smells of lavender. I'm gonna start falling asleep in the middle of this video. The next thing is in this little box. It says mini Victorian picture frame. This is so good because I'm literally moving out of here in like a week, and I'm going to the car boot sales and stuff with my dad at the weekend, because I just want to get loads and loads of cute, like weird looking picture frames. So this is came at the perfect time. Oh, this is so adorable. Tiny little black ornate photo frame. That's so gorgeous. So you could keep like a tiny little picture in there. I think I'd keep that like on my vanity or something, on my desk, and just have something cool and spooky in there. Oh, I love that. That's so amazing. It's like they knew I was moving out. The next thing is in this teeny tiny little pouch, and is a charm for the bracelet.
Oh my god, it's so cute.
It's a teeny tiny little coffin, or is it a tombstone? It's a coffin or a tombstone. And a charm. How cute! Oh my god, love that. Next thing I'm pulling out is a patch that says Lazy Bones in like almost like a Tim Burton style font, so it's black with purple writing on. It's got a little skull on there, a little bat, that's so cute. It'd be good on like the pocket of a jacket. Oh, this is so pretty. A Stillbird pin, custom made, limited edition for Spooky Box Club. How cute is that? That is just like breathtakingly beautiful. That definitely belongs in a Memento Mori theme box. Next thing is a lollipop, and this one is purple and light purple. I haven't actually tried any of my lollipops yet, and I definitely need to, because every time I get one out I'm like, looks so good. And I think this looks like the last thing in here. Oh my god, this is so beautiful. Is a brooch that says at rest. And it's just so ornate and beautiful and looks like a little tombstone. That is just so gorgeous. It's quite like, it's heavy as well. It's like heavy duty. It's not just like cheaply made and gonna fall apart. Like that is, oh, everything is so freaking beautiful. How do they do it? How do they just pick like the best things ever to put into a box? Oh, there was something hidden at the bottom. Oh my god. So it's like in the style, I'll take it out the wrap so you can see it. It's in the style of cross stitch, but it's just a print. So again, this will be perfect in my new house, and it says Tomb Sweet Tomb. Or unless it's like a template for cross stitch. If so, that's really cool. So yeah, now I'll read the card. So the first thing is the custom made steel bird pin, got that. Natural soothing lavender candle, got that. Custom made at rest brooch, mini Victorian picture frame. Custom made coffin charm, it is a coffin. Custom made lazy bones patch, tomb sweet tomb art print, and handcrafted gourmet lollipop. And that is everything. That is box 26. That's what the card looks like. This box was definitely my kind of box. I love anything to do with death, like I said at the start of the video. It's really, really cool. Yeah, I think my favourite thing in the whole box was the teeny tiny picture frame. That's just so gorgeous. This is like my style, fits my style perfectly. Like the photo frame and the pin together. It's like aesthetic as fuck. Oh, so gorgeous. I really hope you guys enjoyed watching this unboxing video. If you're interested in the makeup, I could do a tutorial if you request it. I may end up doing one because it's really fun to do. My eyebrows look really uneven. Yeah, if you end up getting the book, let me know what you think of it in the comments below, and it'll be cool to talk to you guys about. So the channel's more than just like hauls and makeup and stuff. There's more like in-depth content. Maybe I could do a review of it if that's what you guys are into. Yeah, let me know down below what you thought of this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe. I think that's the first time I've mentioned it. So yeah, I'm trying to grow this channel, so like and subscribe. And I'll see you guys next time.